All right. Ready to dive into the world of pumps?
Let's do it.
Today, it's single stage versus multi-stage.
Ooh, a classic matchup.
By the end of this deep dive,
you'll be a pump choosing pro.
No more second guessing at the hardware store.
Exactly. You'll know exactly what you need.
And our guide for this journey.
A report called Multi-Stage versus Single Stage Pumps, Making the Right Choice.
Sounds pretty comprehensive.
It covers all the bases.
So pumps, they're kind of a behind-the-scenes workhorse.
Absolutely essential, though.
For so many things.
Yeah, from keeping our homes running.
To huge industrial processes.
You don't realize how much you rely on pumps until they're not working.
True. And it's easy to assume they're all basically the same.
Right. But there are some key differences.
Especially when you're talking about single-stage versus multi-stage.
That's where things get interesting.
And potentially confusing.
Well, we're here to clear up that confusion.
So let's break it down.
Starting with the basics.
Single-stage, one impeller.
It's the workhorse.
Simple, reliable.
Good for moderate pressure needs.
Okay, that makes sense.
Then you have multi-stage.
Multiple impellers.
Like a team of weightlifters.
Each one adding a boost.
Exactly. So you get those higher pressure capabilities.
For when you need some serious oomph.
Exactly. Things like pumping water uphill.
Or over long distances.
Like in a skyscraper.
Right. You need a powerful pump to get water all the way up there.
Exactly. A multi-stage pump would be perfect for that.
But what about for everyday applications?
Like in a home.
Yeah. Do you always need all that extra pressure?
Not necessarily. It depends on your needs.
And the report mentions efficiency.
That's a big factor.
Does that mean multi-stage pumps always win in that department?
Not always. It's not that simple.
Oh, right.
While multi-stage pumps are generally more efficient for high-pressure situations.
Right, because they're designed for that.
But for simpler tasks, low pressure.
A single stage can actually be more efficient.
Sometimes even more so.
So it's not a one-size-fits-all situation.
You have to consider your specific application.
Which makes sense.
Think about the pressure demands of your system.
That's a key factor.
If you're just watering a small garden,
you probably don't need a super powerful pump.
A single stage would likely be more efficient and cost-effective.
Makes sense.
Now, speaking of cost,
that's always a consideration.
I'm guessing multi-stage pumps are more expensive.
Being more complex and all?
You're right. They usually have a higher upfront cost.
But we need to look at the long game.
Exactly. That's a crucial point.
A multi-stage pump might cost more initially.
But in a high-pressure application?
The energy savings over time?
Could actually make up for that higher initial cost.
Interesting. So it's not just about the sticker price.
It's about the total cost of ownership.
You got to factor in those long-term operating costs.
Exactly. Think about it like this.
Okay. I'm listening.
Let's say you have a car wash.
Okay, I like car washes.
They use high-pressure spray systems.
Right, to blast away all the dirt.
Switching from a single stage to a multi-stage pump in that scenario?
Would it make a difference?
You could save up to 30% on your energy bill.
30%? That's huge.
And that's over the pump's entire lifetime.
So you could be saving thousands of dollars.
Potentially, yes.
Wow. That definitely puts things into perspective.
It's about weighing the upfront costs against the potential long-term savings.
And there might be other factors to consider as well.
Right, like installation complexity.
And potential system upgrades down the road.
Single-stage pumps are often easier to install.
Less piping, less hassle.
But if your needs change in the future,
and you need to expand your system,
a multi-stage pump might offer more flexibility for upgrades.
So it's kind of like choosing between a compact car and a heavy-duty truck.
I like that analogy.
Both can get you around.
But they have different strengths and weaknesses.
Depending on your needs and your budget.
You need to choose the right tool for the job.
And speaking of different needs,
the report dives into some application-specific examples.
Which I thought was really interesting.
It helps to see how these pumps are used in the real world.
Like in industrial settings.
They often need incredibly high pressure capabilities.
For things like chemical processing.
And boiler feed systems.
It's amazing to think about these pumps working behind the scenes.
Keeping these huge industrial operations running smoothly.
But let's shift gears for a moment.
Okay, where are we going?
Let's imagine a more everyday scenario.
Like a residential home.
Yeah, with a sprinkler system.
Maybe a pool.
Exactly. For those everyday needs.
A single-stage pump is often more than enough.
It can handle supplying water to the house.
Running the sprinklers, filling the pool.
All without breaking a sweat.
It's a reliable workhorse for those moderate pressure applications.
So we've covered a lot of ground here.
We've talked about pressure, efficiency, cost.
and even got a glimpse into how these punks operate in different environments.
From industrial plants to cozy homes.
But before we move on to maintenance and reliability.
Another crucial aspect.
I have a question.
I'm all ears.
Is there ever a situation where a single-stage pump could actually outperform a multi-stage pump?
Interesting question.
Even in a high-pressure application?
No, that's something to think about.
Is that even possible?
Or is that like pump heresy? Well, it's not heresy at all. There can be exceptions.
So there's not always a clear-cut win for multi-stage.
Exactly.
So tell me more. When would a single-stage pump be better?
Okay, think about this.
I'm ready.
You need to move a large volume of water.
Got it.
At moderate pressure.
Okay.
But the source is far away.
Like a long way from the house.
Exactly.
Okay, I see where you're going with this.
In that case,
yeah,
a well-designed single-stage pump
with a larger impeller,
bingo,
could actually be more efficient than a multi-stage.
Because it's designed for moving large volumes over distances.
And the multi-stage is all about pressure.
It's like comparing a marathon runner to a sprinter.
I love a good analogy.
The marathon runner might not be the fastest over a short distance.
But they're built for endurance.
Exactly. They can cover long distances efficiently.
So even though multi-stage pumps are often the go-to for high pressure,
right,
there are cases where a single stage can hold its own.
Absolutely.
And our source material, multi-stage versus single-stage pumps, making the right choice.
A great resource, by the way.
It mentions another factor.
An important one.
The type of fluid being pumped.
It's not always just water.
Right. Good point.
They talk about viscosity.
That's the thickness.
Or resistance to flow.
Like molasses.
Exactly.
Compared to water.
Night and day.
Does viscosity affect pump selection?
It's a game changer.
How so?
Think about trying to pump molasses.
Oh, that would be tough.
Compared to water, it's so much thicker.
Requires way more energy to move.
Exactly. And that can affect a pump's efficiency.
And its lifespan, I imagine.
You got it.
So for thicker fluids like molasses, you probably want a multi-stage pump, right?
You might think so.
Because of the higher pressure capability.
It seems logical.
But it's not always the case.
There are nuances.
Wait, really?
While multi-stage pumps are great for generating high pressure, they're not always the best for handling high viscosity fluids.
Okay, now I'm really intrigued.
Tell me more.
So how do you choose the right pump when you're dealing with thicker fluids?
This is where pump design gets fascinating.
I love learning about this stuff.
Me too. It's like a whole hidden world.
So spill the beans.
Some single stage pumps have special impellers.
Designed specifically for viscous fluids.
Exactly. Yeah. It's all about matching the pump to the tasks.
It's not just about pressure.
It's about the pump's inner workings.
And how they interact with the fluid.
You got it.
Mind blown.
Glad you're enjoying this.
I am. Keep going.
So these special impellers,
yeah,
they might have a different shape.
Okay.
Or a slower rotation speed.
Makes sense.
Which allows them to move those thicker fluids more smoothly.
Like using a wide paddle to stir thick batter.
Instead of a whisk.
Perfect analogy.
The paddle is just better suited for that task.
So you really have to match the tool to the job.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
And the report highlights other factors too.
Besides viscosity.
Yeah, like temperature.
Ah, yes, that's important.
And the presence of solids.
This can be tricky.
Imagine pumping hot oil.
Or a slurry with abrasive particles.
You need specialized materials for the pump.
To withstand those harsh conditions.
So choosing the right pump.
It's like being a detective.
Ooh, I like that.
Gathering clues about the fluid.
Viscosity, temperature, composition.
You got it.
And then matching those clues to the pump's capabilities.
You're a natural at this.
Thanks. I'm learning from the best.
And speaking of investigation.
Toganim.
The report also talks about
Go on.
Analyzing your existing pump system.
Okay, interesting.
Even if you're not looking to buy a new pump right now.
So even if everything seems fine on the surface.
You might be missing something.
There could be hidden clues.
That your pump isn't the ideal choice.
Or that it's not operating at peak efficiency. So it's like a pump health checkup.
I love that analogy.
To see if it's in tip-top shape.
Or if there are warning signs.
That you might be overlooking.
You're getting it.
So what kind of warning signs should we be looking for?
The report suggests paying attention to things like noise.
Okay.
Excessive vibration.
That doesn't sound good.
Frequent maintenance needs.
That can get expensive.
Or higher than expected energy bills.
Those are all red flags.
They could be signs that your pump is overworking. Or struggling with the fluid.
Or maybe it's just the wrong pump for the job.
Exactly. It might be time for a replacement.
So even if we're not actively shopping for a pump,
right,
this deep dive can still help us.
Absolutely.
We can troubleshoot our current setup.
And potentially save money in the long run.
On energy and maintenance.
Knowledge is power.
I couldn't agree more.
Understanding how pumps work.
It can help you make better decisions.
About your entire system.
Whether you're replacing a pump.
Optimizing an existing one.
Or just planning for the future. You'll be prepared.
This is great stuff.
I'm glad you're finding it helpful.
I am. But let's be honest.
What's on your mind?
Even with all this information.
Yeah.
Choosing between single stage and multi-stage.
It can still feel overwhelming.
There are so many factors to consider.
It's like standing in the cereal aisle.
With a million options.
And no idea which one to choose.
Exactly. So, for our listeners who are feeling stuck.
Yeah, what's the first step?
Where do they even begin? It's decision time.
The moment of truth.
Picking the right pump.
Single stage or multi-stage?
Where do we start?
Our report, Multi-Stage versus Single Stage Pumps. Making the right choice has a good framework.
They mention a systems level approach.
Yeah, that's key.
Systems level, that sounds kind of technical.
It's simpler than it sounds.
Okay.
Think of it like a factory production line.
Lots of moving parts.
Each machine has a specific job.
And if one breaks down,
the whole system is affected.
Right, everything gets backed
up. Your pump is similar.
It's not just a standalone thing.
It's part of a larger system.
Pipes, valves, filters.
A whole network.
So it's not just about the pump itself.
You have to consider how it interacts with everything else.
The whole ecosystem.
Exactly. Things like pipe size.
Okay.
The layout of your pipes.
Like how many bends and turns there are.
Exactly. And elevation changes.
If the water has to go uphill.
All of that affects pump performance.
So, for example, if you have a long, narrow pipe.
With lots of twists and turns.
A single-stage pump. Might struggle.
To maintain pressure and flow.
It's like trying to force a lot of water through a tiny straw.
But a multi-stage pump.
With its higher pressure.
Could handle that, no problem.
So how can our listeners start thinking about their system?
From this systems level perspective.
Where do they begin?
First, gather information.
About my specific system.
Yeah, what type of fluid are you pumping?
Okay.
What's the flow rate and pressure you need?
Right, those are important.
Distances, elevation changes.
Gotta get all the details.
Once you have that.
Then you can narrow down your choices.
That makes sense, right?
It's like solving a puzzle.
You need all the pieces.
To see the bigger picture.
Exactly. And don't be afraid to ask for help.
If it gets too overwhelming?
There are experts out there.
Like who?
Pump manufacturers, engineers, technicians.
Okay, the pros?
They can analyze your system.
And recommend the best pump.
They can also spot potential issues.
With your current setup.
And suggest ways to optimize it.
So it's like having a coach in your corner.
Guiding you through the process.
Helping you avoid costly mistakes.
Exactly. Choosing a pump.
It's an important decision.
It's an investment.
You want to make the right choice.
For the long term.
And this deep dive has been so helpful.
I'm glad to hear that.
I've learned so much.
About the complexity of pumps.
And how important they are.
They really are the unsung heroes.
Keeping everything running.
From our homes.
To huge industrial plants.
And now our listeners.
They have the knowledge.
To make informed decisions.
About their own pump systems.
Whether they're buying a new pump.
Or just trying to maintain their current one.
So the next time you hear a pump humming.
Take a moment to appreciate it.
It's doing more than you think.
Thanks for joining us on this deep dive.
It's been a pleasure.
And we'll catch you next time.
For another fascinating exploration.
Into the world of engineering marvels.